How are you, football fans? This Sunday, you can stream Fulham v Liverpool and Everton v Chelsea. That's an amazing Paddy's Day lineup for a one-off payment of just €10. To grab a Now TV Sky Sports Day Pass and only pay for the games that matter to you, search Now TV today. Content streamed via internet, full terms at nowtv.com.
Uplifting lives one day at a time. Kimmie Kim and Elation Radio. They're here to get your day going fine. Kimmie Kim and Elation Radio. Kimmie Kim and Elation Radio. Kimmie Kim and Elation Radio.
And here's your host, Miss Kim Robinson.
God has made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you for tuning in to Fellowship Friday. I love that song. I want to go because I know every day I try to get that well done verdict, and that was Lady Paul. I want to go, and we have her on today, and I'm so happy to have her on. So this is the day that the Lord has made, and we're going to rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. What a great day in the Lord. We are thankful for our Friday. So before we bring my sister on, let's first go to the Father in prayer, because I know this is going to be a fellowshipping time, because that's the when you understand who you are and whose you are in the Lord, you want to go and be with him and not with the world. So let's go to the Father in prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, thank you once again for your grace. Thank you for your mercy, Father God. Thank you for making ways out of no way. And Father God, we just want to please you. We just want to honor you because you are worthy to be praised. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. God, you are so worthy just to give us an opportunity to restore the relationship through Jesus Christ. It's just simply amazing, Father God. And I don't know where I would be without you, because I need your strength, because I cannot operate on my strength, because I fall short each time. So I thank you, Father God, for just giving me an opportunity to know you through Jesus. And we're going to continue on making this prayer, and we're going to say hallelujah in Jesus' name. Amen. Wow. Amen. Good morning, Lady Paul. How you doing?
Hello, hello. I am so well. Thank you. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Now, I want to make sure I said it right. It's Sister Crystal J, right?
That's correct. Crystal J. Crystal J. Paul.
I love that. Wow. I call you Lady Paul because I want to make sure I said the first name right.
That's fine. You know,
I love your
if
name.
I work. Thank you. It's a combination of my parents' names. If I were to get paid for every time my name was misspelled or mispronounced, I'd be rich. So it's okay. I get it all the time. It's fine. It's fine. Yes.
You know, names are important, and I just want to make sure
that's
I said
true.
That is so beautiful to have your mother's
thank
name
you.
And your father's name in one.
That's
wow,
correct.
This is for you.
That's
I'm
correct.
Just honored
yes.
to have you.
Thank you very much.
Wow.
Thank you for your words.
No, you're
your
welcome.
Words as well. Yes, yes.
You're amazing. I love that song. But before we get to that song, how are you doing on Friday?
Oh, I am well. I am feeling so full. I'm feeling so joyful. It's beyond happy. It's joyful, especially today, you know. It's another day that God has made, and I'm just loving what he's doing in my life, and I'm so grateful for it. Humbled by it and just amazed.
Well, I'm the humble one, and wow, where are you from? Because you have a wonderful accent.
Oh yes, I'm from Jamaica. I'm Jamaican. I live in Barbados, but I'm Jamaican.
Wow, I need to come to Jamaica because I have not gone, and I know you guys
know
how to, because I love to eat and I love to dance
yeah.
and I love to just have a good time. So
that's good.
I would definitely need to keep in contact with you. So.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, we shall, definitely. Definitely.
So Jamaican, and you are powerful in the Lord. That is simply amazing.
Yes.
So tell the listeners,
amen.
Who is Lady Paul?
Okay, well, I'm Crystal J. Paul. I was born and raised in Jamaica. I love the Lord. I got saved at age 5. I've been singing since age 3, and on some kind of stage since I was 5 years old. But I grew up in a family of singers, not artists, just singers. All my mother's relatives, her siblings, and everybody can sing. So, you know, we were always singing, and I was always singing at church. I was very involved in church growing up, and in 2004, I got married and came to Barbados, and I've been living here since. And it's been a really great journey. You know, it's had its ups and downs. I'm married to a pastor.
Uh-huh.
He's Reverend Roger Paul. Yes, and we'll be celebrating
wow.
our 15th wedding anniversary on Wednesday. Yeah, so I'm very happy about that. Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you.
I love
yes,
to hear that
yes.
because I really believe that family is important, and it sounds like you
yes.
are having a great time with that ministry as well.
Yes.
because I still believe
amen. God has been good.
Ministry.
That's right. That's right. God has been good. God has been good. So in 2015, in 2015, God called me to really launch out. And since then, I've been, you know, singing on more public stages, and I've shared stages with some international artists as well here and overseas. And I'm just so thankful for where God has been leading me. That is, I Wanna Go is my second song, the second of many to come, praise the Lord. So I'm looking forward to it. And, you know, it's amazing because God has just given me a passion for singing that I didn't have before. Just a passion for reaching out and launching out. It's, you know, when God calls you, he just puts in you what it is that you need to do the work. And there's this purposeful passion, you know, to fulfill my purpose and, you know, to go where he wants me to go and to be who he wants me to be and just reach who he wants me to reach. And that is the message that I proclaim for each and every one of us. Yes.
And that song, it says everything that you just said.
Yes. Amen. That's right.
Said you want to go with him. Yeah, I want to go with
him.
That's
right.
You know,
that's right.
He is the ultimate, you know. He gives you everything
amen.
You need. And you've been
amen.
Saved for 5 years old. Wow. That
yes,
is simply
yes,
amazing.
I remember it very well.
So did you ever stray away? Because I'm going to be honest, I got saved at 12, and I didn't understand the feeling after this. After I got my salvation, because I had really, that was really the Holy Ghost, but I didn't know how to, you know, receive it properly. Did
you
stray away and come back, or did you just continue on with your journey? Because I'm going to be honest, I did stray away. Even though I still went to church.
Well, that's fine.
But
well, you know,
like
how it is. Exactly. Because, I mean, you know, I was brought up in a Christian home, but as a teenager, of course, there are different things that you would have dabbled in and experimented in. And unfortunately, there are things that you dabble and experiment in that stay with you for life. You know, the key thing, when I was 16, I started to make a turnaround. And when I was 18, and then between 18 and 21, that's when I really rededicated my life to the Lord. And, you know, got back on track.
Wow.
Because it's so easy when you grow up in church. It's easy to play church. It's easy to speak the jargon. You know what to say and how to say it. You know, but we
that
can fool people, but we can't fool God.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yes.
Right. Religion is easy, but a relationship with God, he knows who you are for real. And you can't fool him. So, you know, we should live our lives to please him and not to please other people, because it, you know, we're not going to get anywhere with him doing that. So, so yes, I mean, there were times, you know, I did do things that I was not supposed to be doing and strayed a bit, but I was still at least in that circle. So I still had that influence, but it's when I was really older that I really said, you know what? No more playing. This is it for real.
Wow. You know,
yes.
I knew you were going to be a real coach. You would, my brother, Mr.
Carlton
McConnell. And
I
knew you were going to be wonderful and so filled with the Holy Spirit, because I love dealing with real people, because we're dealing with real problems right now with the youth.
Yes.
They're thinking that we are so perfect, that we've been this way all our lives, but God has to come inside of us. So with that being said,
That's
how
great.
Do you reach out to the young people with your music?
How do I reach out to the young people with my music? Well, I work with young people, and I really...
That is really beautiful. They will receive your music, because I love it. I love it.
Oh, well, amen.
Amen.
Amen. You know, I believe in just breaking things down in a way for them to be able to understand. Because whereas I would have been brought up in church, obviously not everybody is brought up in church. And so it's easy for us to speak over their heads, because we know what to say and how to say it, and it can sound highfalutin. So I try to put things in their terms. So for example, even if I were to use my song and to be before a group of young people, I would speak to them and say, you know what? this is what you're supposed to be doing. It's not just a matter of living your life, but then God has a plan for you. And, you know, use their jargon and use their terms in order to relate it to the song so that they can better understand. Mm-hmm. So that
That's
is what
beautiful.
I would do, yes. Yes.
That's beautiful.
Yes, yes.
Now, to your wonderful anointed.
Amen.
I can't wait until you come back on to the 15th because it was my fault with the mess up with the date. So I've been playing
That's
on
okay.
the radio in rotation. I'm sorry. I can't wait until you come back.
Oh, praise God. You know what? All in its appointed time. So I'm thankful. I really am. Thank you very much.
And so with that being said, give us a synopsis of I Want to Go. How did you come
okay,
up with
well,
the song, and what was the synopsis, and how did you do it? It was just amazing. It's a worship song for me when I listen
yes.
to it.
Yes. Praise God. Praise God. Well, my husband wrote this song, and he composed
oh
he did the melody as well, the tune. Yes, yes.
Oh, my.
Yes. He wrote my first song
for him.
As well. Yeah, that's right. Amen to that. And
wow.
So he wrote the song because
wow.
we were amen, amen. We were both at a time where we just wanted to do, still do, want to do more for God. And I'm all about fulfilling your purpose. Ever since God called me, you know, he's been teaching me and instructing me all about knowing who you are and fulfilling your purpose in him, because I believe that each of us was born with a gift, and we're born
yeah.
with gifts to glorify him in the earth, to build up those around us. So, you know, I Want to Go is simply that. It's simply the desire to fulfill your purpose using your gifts in the earth. So it's just amazing that we were both at that point. And, you know, the Lord put this song, the words of this song in his mind. And he's not very insistent as to, okay, this is how the tune should be for a song. My first song, it was co-written by another artist, you know, and he's usually
mm-hmm.
flexible, but for the tune for this one, he was like, no, please, you know, let's just do it this way. So he had the tune, and then I just put my own interpretation to the tune. And, you know, just be guided by the Holy Spirit as to how to interpret the song. Because a song has to speak to me before I sing it. Even if it's not my song that I'm singing on a stage.
That's beautiful.
It has to speak to me first, because God is using me
yeah.
to speak to the people. So I speak to people in song. So, yeah,
wow.
it has to speak to me first. So it's a matter of interpreting the song. I didn't change the tune much, but... you know, because I said, you know what, he's not very insistent, so the Lord must be allowing this for a reason, you know. So I just put
wow.
my own interpretation to the song, and it was, you know, we've got it produced here by Life Shift Records, and it just came together really well, and I was happy to see how God, I mean, you know, this was bathed in prayer and fasting, you know, because I believe in
yeah.
that totally. Totally, because it's a song for the earth. It's not mine, but it's God using it to build people up in this earth. And, you know, and I'm seeing it come to fruition, and I'm just so humbled and thankful by that.
Wow. I'm just so amazed
yeah.
by your service to your servitude spirit, your humbling spirit. And you do
yeah.
definitely have the gift of singing. And just to know that you're giving that back to God allows me to know
Amen.
That you know who you are. And whose you are, and it's
Amen.
Fun, you know, for the Lord.
That's
Tell
right.
the listeners
That's
how
right.
much fun you're having in the Lord, because people think when you're a believer that all you do is church, 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 but church is really in you. How much fun are you having
yes.
with your gifts?
Oh, wow. well, let's just say it's allowing me to go places that I never thought that I... Hey, I'm on the Kimmie Kim. I'm speaking with Kimmie Kim right now. I mean, that in itself,
well,
right?
I think it's a lady crystal day, so it's an honor both ways, so let's do this. And I would love to feature you in Elation Magazine this year, because
Whoa,
your
wow.
spirit is so humbling. You have a humbling spirit
Amen.
That allows
Amen.
You to really be, I mean, it's a unique spirit that, when you know that you are of God and you're doing it for him, it's humbling. It's amazing.
Amen.
And you're having fun. And We have fun.
Yes.
I'm honored.
Yes,
so.
Of course. Amen. Amen. So I'm thankful for that, and I'm just thankful for what God does. And I'm like, you kind of have fun. I mean, my husband and I we're crazy people, you know. We just have
I'm
fun.
Crazy too, so.
Yeah, exactly. So you know,
in
you,
the Lord, of course.
Why not? I mean, in the Lord, of course, because you still honor Him, and you know, you still do what it is that you have to do in Him. But I mean, we love to laugh
it's
and
fun.
Make a lot of joke, and yeah, it's good. Laughter is good medicine, after all, so why not?
Absolutely, because we serve a God who has humor. He already knew that we couldn't do it.
That's right.
Even in the first family, he already knew that they weren't able to fulfill the promise that he wanted Jesus to fulfill. He already knew that. That's why
that's
he has
right.
laughter in him as well.
Amen.
So, yeah,
amen.
You know,
amen.
You know,
that's
right. We're born of flesh. Flesh cannot really enter in the kingdom, but we needed the second Adam. But that being said, what is one of your favorite books in the Bible?
Wow, one of my favorite books. What? Oh, chapters. Okay, well, actually recently on Sunday I presented with the WIN conference, Women's International Network. It's on Facebook Live, and I went through Judges chapters 6-8.
Wow.
Now, God had
okay.
me in Judges chapter 6. That's the story of Gideon. God had me in Judges chapter 6 for over a year. And then I had to,
wow.
I spoke on it at a ladies function last year in Nevis. And then the Lord just continued, he would not, I kid you not, he would not let me move from Judges chapter 6 for at least a year. And then I went to Judges chapter 7 and Judges chapter 8, but it I mean, there's so much to learn from it, because Gideon saw himself as a nobody. He said he was the poorest. Mm-hmm. He was from the poorest family and the least in the poorest family. But then God took the time to visit him and called him mighty mm-hmm. man of valor, and he didn't believe it. But it's just amazing to see how God used this man who thought he was nothing, you know, gave mm-hmm. him an unconventional way to defeat the Midianites and the Amalekites and the children of the East, using only 300 yeah. men against hundreds of thousands of men, using trumpets, pitchers, and lamps to make noise, you know. And in the same way God gave Gideon that unconventional way to defeat those people, God can use us in mysterious ways and give us unconventional ways to do what we need to do to accomplish our purpose in the earth. And it's just a matter of us believing that. And it's amazing even to see at the end of Gideon's life how the people wanted him to be king, and you know, his enemies saw him as resembling the children of a king, the child of a king. And that is what God does when a life is surrendered to him, you know. And
yeah.
so I would definitely say that story has impacted my life a great deal, that with God, nothing is impossible.
Exactly. With God, all things are possible. With man, it's impossible. Because one thing that's a beautiful example, because one thing I've noticed, God uses the underdog for his purpose.
That's right.
He doesn't use the prideful for his
right,
journey.
Right.
He doesn't use them because
right.
they think they're above God. Wow.
And
that is amazing,
that's right.
judges.
That's right. That's
so,
right.
I just want to thank you for coming on, and I would love for us to stay in contact, and I'm on Facebook. I would look for you as well. And you're just
sure,
amazing,
yes.
lady.
Sure. Thank you.
And
thank you. Praise God for that.
No, thank you for your time, because I know you have a busy schedule. So before we leave, I would like for you to give out your contact information and then a nugget for the remaining week. And I would love for you to pray us out.
Oh, wow. Sure, sure. Okay, well, my name is Crystal J. Paul. Just to spell it, it's KristoJayPaul. And you can contact me on Instagram and Twitter at Crystal J. Paul. On Facebook, Crystal J. Paul. Or my Facebook page, Crystal J. Paul Worship. And, well, as you mentioned, Brother Carlton, he is definitely Well, I'm telling you, he's something else. You know, he's doing really well. So you can contact him as well to reach me.
Yes.
His number is 972-834-5936. And, you know, I'm just so thankful for what God is doing. So, yes.
And he's doing a great work in you, because I just feel your music, and I know it's going to be a stellar time for you very, very soon this year. I just see it.
Amen.
Your music
Amen.
Is so amazing. It's something that we really need. And it has
Amen.
A pitch for the young people to maintain their attention. So
Amen.
I'm going to be quiet.
That's right.
And this is your time. Give us something that we can, like a life nugget for the remaining week, and then pray us out. And I just want to thank you for coming on to Fellowship Friday. This was an honor for me to really get to know you. I know it's very hard to do in 30 minutes, but I'm going to reach out to my brother, because I need you to be a feature in the magazine, because I want
Amen.
To really support your music. Your music is awesome.
Praise God. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, one of my favorite verses is Luke chapter 1, verse 37. And simply just what we said just now, for with God nothing shall be impossible. And I just want everybody listening right now to just remember that when you have God in your life, there is absolutely nothing you cannot achieve. That all simply means all. But we tend to want to limit God, but let's not limit God. Let's just believe him to do great works and the impossible, and to continue to work miracles and great miracles in us and through us. And when we really yield ourselves, we'll find that he will do exceeding abundantly above all that we think or imagine. All right, so let me pray now. Almighty God and Heavenly Father, thank you so much, dear God, for this time, this time on Elation Radio. I just pray, dear God, that those who are listening right now, that would have been blessed, that they would have been inspired, dear God, to move forward in you, oh God. Help us to all see you for who you are and not who we want you to be, to not be holding you as a convenient God, but to truly surrender our lives to you, dear God. It's only when we surrender our lives that you can use us the way you want to use us, dear God. Help us to understand that we can accomplish our purpose, the purpose that you have created us for, that we can accomplish our purpose in the earth, oh God, and not be afraid to step out in the water, not be afraid, dear God, to act in faith. Lord, it's easy to say we have faith, but faith without works is dead. I pray, dear God, that we'll be purposeful people and that we'll work the things that you would have us to work, oh God. Help us, dear God, to be free in you, oh God, to understand that, you know, even though we can accomplish our purpose in you can still give us the ability to laugh and have fun and enjoy ourselves, all because you allow us to do it, dear God. And thank you so much for being the God that you are, that we can accomplish and appreciate these things, oh God. Lord, I thank you so much for Kimmie Kim. Thank you, dear God, for allowing me to be sharing this space on radio with her. I pray, dear God, that you continue to keep her, that you continue to mold her, you touch her life, oh God. I pray, dear God, for healing where there's healing necessary. I pray, dear God, that, Lord, you touch her and that you continue to use her, dear God, as a vessel to speak to the people wherever they are and to really touch their lives, to be in total communication, dear God, totally in you, dear God. And that she will continue to allow herself to be used in this way, dear God. I pray that you continue to enlarge her borders, that, Father, she will see you, dear God, and know that all things are possible with you as well. Lord, I give you the glory, I give you the honor, I give you the praise for what you're going to do in the magnificent and mighty and powerful name of Jesus Christ. Amen.